The Boston Bruins offense struggled for much of the game, but they found their scoring touch in the third period and rallied to overcome 2-1-goal deficits to defeat the slumping Detroit Red Wings 3-2 in overtime. Welcome to the Boston Bruins newsfeed post-game recap. This is Joe Danker reporting for CLNS, a leading online provider of audiovisual coverage of the Boston Bruins. On a snowy night in Detroit, in a half-filled Little Caesars Arena, the Bruins came from behind to hand the Red Wings, who have won only one of their past 11 games, an overtime loss. The win is the Bruins' 15th of the year to go with 9 losses and 4 overtime losses and gives the Bees 34 points and solidifies their hold on third place in the Atlantic Division. The Red Wings fall to 11, 13, and 7 for 29 points, and they sit in 6th place in the Atlantic. The game winner came just 35 seconds into overtime when Tory Krug found Brad Marchand breaking in on Red Wings goalie Jimmy Howard. Marshy deftly deked to his backhand, held off the defender, and lifted the game winner over Howard at a ridiculous angle for his 12th goal of the season. Winger David Pastrnak made sure the game went into overtime with a one-time shot from the left slot off a seeing-eye feed from Marchand with just a minute and a half to play, and goalie Tuukka Rask on the bench. It was Pasta's 15th goal of the year, and it tied the game at 2. The game had been a slog for much of the first two periods, as the Red Wings defense was active and aggressive on the puck, and very accurate with their sticks in passing and shooting lanes. It seemed every time the Bruins wound up to shoot or pass, a Red Wings stick or skate was in the way. In fact, the Bruins were so inept, they actually went 18 minutes across the first and second periods without landing a single shot on goal. The Red Wings, however, were not quite as awful. They peppered Rask all game and took advantage of a terrible penalty call on Patrice Bergeron to take a 1-0 lead midway through the second on a power play goal by Tomas Tatar, his 9th score of the year. The Bruins would even things up early in the third period, skating as if they just got their manhood challenged between periods by Bruce Cassidy. The Bees started the third flying, and it was the fourth line that got their dirty work done and cracked the code to scoring on the Red Wings with a typical checking line type of goal. A net front scrum with bodies flying around and sticks clashing ended with the puck slipping by Howard off the stick of Noel Achari for his 2nd goal of the year, assisted by Tim Schaller. With just over 8 minutes to play and the score tied at 1, the Bruins went on the power play. But Dylan Larkin spun Pastrnak around at the Red Wing blue line and took a feed from Darren Helm to break in alone on Rask and flip a backhander over the goalie's shoulder for his 5th of the season, a potentially back-breaking shorthanded goal. But the Bruins wouldn't quit. They aggressively pulled Rask for an extra skater with 2.5 minutes to play, and the resulting Pastrnak goal sent the game into overtime where Brad Marchand would go to work. The Bruins head home to host the Washington Capitals on Thursday at 7 p.m. Be sure to come to clnsmedia.com for all your Bruins coverage. The all-new CLNS Media website has launched at clnsmedia.com. clnsmedia.com is now the home of this podcast and also 40-plus other podcasts and vidcasts in the world of sports, finance, comedy, and lifestyles. We are so excited to have our show featured on the new CLNS Media website. Support our network by checking this episode out at clnsmedia.com. That's clnsmedia.com. This has been Joe Danker for CLNS.